After I published last week's video on the new C# 11 keyword required, I had a question from a subscriber called TechButabrot asking how that related to the older required attribute that we can put onto properties for various reasons. And so I thought I'd have a bit of a look at that this week, because actually they are doing rather different things. Although it's the same word, required, the required attribute actually relates more to the nullable reference types that came in C# 8. And in fact, those nullable reference types have really superseded the required attribute, whereas the required keyword is brand new and still very important. So let's take a look at that. And what I've got here is an MVC application in which I've got a very simple model called book, and there we've got ID, title, year, and author. And I've configured this project so far so that we've disabled nullable. So this is not going to have nullable reference types. And we'll see why. I'll add it in later just to show the difference between them. Also, what I've done in here is just configured this for using SQLite. So just connecting to a database called library.db. So to start with, let's just take that book and use it to generate the database. So we'll go to the Package Manager console, and I'll do an add migration and just call it initial create and run that. And then we'll do the update database and generate the database. And we can see it's appeared there. And if we go to the SQLite Compact Toolbox, which is a plugin that you can get to look at SQLite databases, and just refresh the connection, then we can see in there we've got that table books, and it's got an ID, title, year, and author. And if we just check those, we can see that the two integers, because they're value types, are there as not null, but the two strings, because they're reference types, are there as null. So we're allowed to have null in those string columns. And that was really what the required attribute was introduced for, certainly at this end of things, so that we can specify that a particular column should be not null. So if I go to, say, my title, and make that required, just get hold of the namespace, and then let's update the database. So we'll call this just step one, and then refresh the connection. And now if we look at that table, we can see a slight difference that title is now not null. So that was the one that we put the required on, and that was interpreted when we did the code first generation, that meant title is not null. So we can have that, and that's what the required attribute means. But the required keyword does nothing at all on there. If I just put required on there, that now means that obviously when we create a book, we have to provide a title, but it doesn't have any effect here. So if we just do another update on the database and reconnect, we can see that our title is now nullable again, so that required has had no effect upon it. So a very clear distinction between them there. The required attribute affects what is generated when we do the code first generation. The required keyword has nothing to do with that. That's just about object initialization in code, as we saw in the previous video. Let's now, though, introduce nullable reference types. So let's go to the project and change that setting so that this is now going to be enabled. And now let's make a couple of these things nullable. So let's say that the year is optional. That's just a nullable value type, but also the author is optional. That's a nullable reference type. And in order to do that, we'll have to initialize that. So we'll just set that for now as an empty string. Then once again, let's do another generation of the database and go back to take a look at it. And now we can see that we've actually achieved the same thing, but without the required attribute at all, because we've got the year as nullable because it's got the question mark. We've got the author as nullable because it's got the question mark, but the title and obviously the ID, because they're not nullable, no question marks, are there as not null. So in terms of the code first generation, we don't need the required attribute anymore because it will read things off the nullable or otherwise that we have in the code. Now, actually related to this, there is another potentially nice feature of that required keyword. You'll notice here, because I've got this non-nullable string, I'm having to set it to a blank so that it's got an initial value. And if I miss that off, then I'll get a warning about title being non-nullable but not being initialized, therefore it would be defaulting to null. And that would be breaking the rules. So what you can do is put required on there, and that gets rid of the warning. But because objects of this book class are always going to be generated and populated through the connection to the database, it doesn't really matter that that is required. We're not going to be creating it for ourselves through the constructor anyway. So that's a neat little additional feature we have with required to avoid those warnings about nullable types on objects, particularly entities like this that are initialized elsewhere through some kind of reflection. So that's the database end of things with the required attribute, but it also has meaning when you're using it, certainly in MVC, on views to determine which fields, when a user fills it in on the website, are required and which aren't required. So let's take a look at that. So let's firstly go to our controllers and add in here a new controller, and we'll get this all to be done using scaffolding because we've already got the DB context. And so we'll just go for book as the model class. You can see I've already got this library context there. Call it books controller, click add. And you'll notice here actually a bug that I spotted in Visual Studio that is related to the keyword required. And you'll see I'm getting this error saying could not get the reflection type for DB context. I don't know exactly what's going wrong here, but I've discovered it's because we've got the required keyword within our model, and for some reason the scaffolder's not coping with that. So all we need to do is just temporarily take that off, and then I'll do the same thing again. So add a controller, same details, add that. And that works fine, and it's generated our controller for us. It's generated the appropriate views for us, so everything done for us. And now having done that, I can just go back to the model and put the required keyword back on. So just something to watch out for. Very unhelpful error message, but easy to solve once you know what's going on. And now if we run that up and drag over the browser, then obviously we've got no data in there. And what I could do is create a new one. So let's just put in a book, Dr. No, 1954 by Ian Fleming. All of that's okay. And we're back on the index page with all of those. But now let's see what we can do in terms of required fields. So let's edit that. And if we just take a look back at our code, then we can see that at the moment, the title, well, it says required, but that, remember, isn't really important. The important thing is that the string is not nullable, whereas the author is nullable. So what we'll see is, if I were to try and miss off the title and save that, then we get an error saying that the field is required. If I put that back on and try to miss off the author, then that's perfectly okay. And similarly, if I edit that and try to miss off the year, that's okay because both of those we saw are nullable types with that question mark that we had there. That, again, is achieving the same as the required attribute. So if we muck around with this a little bit, let's, on that title, let's make that now a nullable string. And we'd better regenerate the database because that's going to make a difference in the database. So let's go for step four here. And so now when we run that up, we'll be able to edit that and give it a blank title as well. Perfectly happy, not very much use. And that is something that traditionally we would have fixed with the required attribute. So if I now go back to my book and put the required attribute on there, and again, let's regenerate the database. Not that that's necessary for what I'm showing you here, but it's just so it's consistent when we write the data back. But the important change is what's happened in the view. Because now, when we run that and edit, and once again, when we try and save that, we're told the title field is required. So in terms of both the database and the views, the required attribute does exactly the same as it being non-nullable. So non-nullable is required, nullable is missing off the required, but it's just much easier in terms of code to do it with the question mark rather than having the attribute. And also it goes beyond that because the required attribute is only looked at by the code first generation or by the Razor view generator, whereas the question mark for nullable or not nullable is checked everywhere in your code, because that's checked by the compiler. Because basically keywords and language features like the question mark, like
the required
keyword, are checked by the compiler, whereas attributes, although some of them are checked by the compiler, generally they are checked by separate tools. So that's the difference between them. The required keyword is useful to make sure that when we are constructing an object in our own code, we don't miss off any required features. And it's also useful for initializing a non-nullable string or non-nullable reference type in general. The required attribute is pretty much the same as having a non-nullable type, be it a reference type or a value type, and therefore is no longer necessary because we can just miss off that question mark. And in terms of what the Razor engine and the database generation were doing, that's exactly the same as with the required attribute. So I hope that was helpful. It was an interesting question because it's a subtle distinction, two things, exactly the same word required, but one the attribute, one the keyword, having completely different meanings. If there are any other questions like that on things that are confusing, that are ambiguous in C#, do leave me a message in the comments and I'll try to address them. But I hope you enjoyed that. And if you did, do subscribe, do click like, and I'll see you next time.